What's up, everybody? We are back. Welcome to the Tarzan Show. Welcome to the greatest show on earth. Today, we have a lot of stuff to do. We got a lot of cage cleaning. We got to do some trimming inside. Everything is kind of overgrown. We're getting so much rain down here. And these plants are kind of taking over my habitat. So I got to go through. I got to trim up a bunch, check on the kids, and I'm going to bring you guys with me. Stay tuned.
Thank you. This is another day in my crazy life. Washing clothes, Yeezys on the floor, monkeys running around, feeding kitty cats. Where you at, Faz?
Faz
Antonio. Antonio. Hey, Antonio. Currently watching Tarzan and Mikasa with mi novia.
Why, papito, why? Que me lo mismo.
I love you guys. Your boy's back to filming, bitch.
We take on a fighter 3 fights in who has generated this kind of buzz and attention for himself. No, not my man, I cannot.
What can everybody expect from this fight on Sunday?
A movie, a knockout, a historical moment. I'ma turn him into a meme.
Make us cry, everybody. One more time, give it up for Jake Paul!
Boxing training at the level which you're doing it is not easy. It does seem like there's a big difference between boxing training and MMA training.
I feel like for me, I told myself, man, I wish I would've did this a long time ago. Tyron Woodley represents a danger, a skill level that Jake's 3 opponents haven't yet. Look, man, I love boxing. I fell in love with it. I feel like I was put on this earth to fight. My whole life has been a fight, you know? I've never got anything handed to me, so I feel like I'm at home. This is more than just fighting. This is about my purpose to create history. I'm calling out the boxing world. I'm here. I'm not going nowhere. I punch hard, I work hard, and I got the best team behind me. This is a war to me. I'm locked in. This is game shit. I'm going out there hurt.
Oh, wow. Oh,
what the hell is Mike doing in this gym right now? Listening to fucking Showtime with Jake Paul and Tyron Woodley. Look, I tell you what, one of these YouTubers better not let me put the paws on him. But until then, I'ma keep training. If anybody wanna give me a free couple $1 million to beat their ass, your boy is here. I'm just trying to cut some fucking wood. And film at the same time, because it's just definitely not happening. But yeah, man, anyways, I'm cutting, I'm filming. Just put a floor in halfway. I put that side in. So, what a day. I'll check back in. Yo, what's up, everybody? Good afternoon. It's a windy day today, and right now I am trying to work out and finish also this floor that I started. Now, I'm not sure if I don't even know how to really put this, but like, it's gonna be a tough one today. Tough vlog. I'm trying to find the right lighting so you guys can see me or whatnot, because it's like different shadows and shit like that. I zoomed in. God damn it. Let me fix this, guys. I'm sorry. See, I'm not like a technical. I'm not a tech guy by any. I'm a caveman by everything. But anyways, I am building a floor for my gym. I had put grass in it a couple, about a year and a half ago, and all my goats would go in there every single night and shit on my grass and eat my grass until it just died. And then I was just walking through a shit infested gym. Every time I would have to work out, I would have to clean the shit before I worked out, or I would be stepping in shit. I got tired of it. Everywhere I have a covering, it was shit. So everywhere I have like a floor or something that has a covering at night, I gotta make sure I have a fence on it, and the fence is high enough because I got big goats, and the goats would jump over the gate, or you guys get it. They would just shit everywhere. So right now I'm cleaning up my garage, aka my gym, and I'm just sweeping shit off my floor that I've been trying to build all day yesterday. I live a crazy life, man. I really can't like explain it much. I just go with the daily flow of the wind, I guess, of life. The wind of life just takes me on whatever journey it wants to go on. And I don't fight the current. I also have a freaking octagon in the backyard with no covering on it. I gotta build something to cover it. I bought it and I didn't want to buy it, and like they deliver it and I didn't know how to put it together, or it had some pieces missing, so I had to make sure it was there. So there it is. So again, my life is a little crazy. Again, I don't know what to, I can't explain it sometimes, but I can show you better than I can tell you. I'm more of a, you know, less talking, more doing type of person. That's why I haven't been vlogging much. You know, I hate the talking. I just like to do stuff, you know. And now that my camera's back fixed again, I'm gonna get a tripod, slap that camera up, and just do stuff, and you guys can tune in. I might be doing some voiceovers, so I might play some music while I'm cleaning or something, or doing something, and you guys will hear me talk, but stay tuned. All right, I'm alive. Let's fucking go, Jones!
Hey, you in life then, now you better kill me. We the best. I'm gonna hurt you, but you better try to hurt me.
Another one. DJ Khaled! Scratched a million off my check list 3 years ago. At 2 zeros to the line, I'm gonna get for more. If my life do what I wanna be with different folks. You know the pick and roll, I pick her up and send her home. I got rich, I scroll, get them in and get them gone. You know, Trappy just got out, I ain't have to put them on. We the ones who got the numbers to put the city on. It's the middle of the summer, I got a hoodie on. My demon time ain't nothing nice. I try not to wear nothing tight. I came up off the shoe nice. Yeah. My little brother ain't living right. My sister, them doing all right. My cousin, them still serving life. Yeah. Seen the robber, robber digging. I seen the preacher get caught for cheating. I break the bank for one of my peeps. I said I'm the one they didn't believe. I show them the facts, then they all need me. I'ma get cake as long as I'm breathing. They making it hard. She really is. Yeah. Yeah, 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 yeah. I'ma turn up on a hater every chance that I get. I'm on the biggest watch they got. Don't care if that shit hurt my wrist. All these hoes fuck on us all. I wish I would claim that bitch. They get hard when they get guns. We got a hood full of sticks. Soon as they say we can't come, you know we'll run around that bitch. You can miss me with that shit. You know I live in the mix. Money, cars, and clothes, and hoes. You know I live in the mix. Money, cars, and clothes, and hoes. Yeah. She think I'm a regular rapper. I'm not. One person come tell me we fucking you block. Watch me run this shit to the tip of this top. Yeah.
Keep going.
Put my kids in Givenchy, she must ain't 1 + 1 = 3. I can't support you personally. She don't got a mortgage, move in with it. Me, these niggas be capping them cars, be leased. Youngest in charge, I speak for the streets. I was gnawed and gnawed, they woke up with beef. Struggle with maybe we used to have water for dinner. We didn't have nothing to eat. Soon as I get on his ass, they gon' look on me bad. I'm like, damn, he was fucking with me. Yeah. I'ma turn up on a hater every chance that I get. I'm on the biggest watcher they got. Don't care if that shit hurt my wrist. All these hoes fuck on us all. I wish I would claim that bitch. They get hard when they get guns. We got a hood full of sticks. Soon as they say we can't come, you know we'll run around that bitch. You can miss me with that shit. You know I live in the mix. Money, cars, and clothes, and hoes. You know I live in the mix. Money, cars, and clothes, and hoes.
I'm from the trench. Nigga be tucked on the net, but really be there for attention. Busy be talking like they really rich, but really be begging me under my pitch. I give a 40-50,000 cash to start up a Benz. I spend that shit at the Nims. I ride the fucking car for 1 to 4 years just to get out of her feelings. I'm in the Lambo, truck in my hood, nobody gon' tell me shit. Going to Cali, I pick my weed for sure, nobody gon' mail me shit. Dice gang, craps a CeeLo, I need cash, don't sell me shit. Baby, got this hood, I'm smashing, you can tell they really rich. Drop the low, ain't no room right now, I took her to the O. Then I put up on the Lamb, cause she a fan of Booney Mo. I got the city on lock, fucking up all the ops. I'll be around with 3 minutes.
six in the phantom. Black Rose truck with the all white century mammy. I'm sitting on Panda. I love my cousin, she was a dancer. I love my brother, he was a scammer. Sit on my lap cause I'm pulling her tracks. And I fall from the back and she calling me handsome.
What a freaking life. God is good, man. Chase your dreams, pray about your dreams, get up early, work for your dreams, stay up late, work for your dreams, take breaks, but get back and work for yourself and for your dreams and keep praying. And bring your brothers and your sisters along with you, bring your family with you. It's lonely at the top, but not when you got your brothers and your sisters or your family. Lesser Tamandua, Tamandua. Tamandua. Now those claws got me earlier. No joke. All right, guys. Well, you guys saw. We came conquered, and I'll see you guys in the morning. I got some stuff to do in here overnight, so I'll give you guys some updates tomorrow. Peace. What's up, guys? Doing my weekly fruit run, and as you guys can see, it's a storming out here.
Now, I'm picking up all types of fruits and veggies for the kids, but the rain is coming down. So,
there's a lot of times where I'm picking out a bunch of fresh fruits and greens for the kids, but there's also times where there's a whole bunch of like papayas that aren't good for human consumption, but my tortoises and a few of my iguanas would love these guys. So I'm picking up some big boxes of this old papaya, and I'm gonna bring it home. I got some plums down there, I got some bananas and some star fruit. So the kids are gonna be fully happy and healthy this week. Different variety of a diet. You guys know I always feed in Missouri and all types of stuff, but I'm showing you guys how crazy this weather can get at the end of rainy season out here. So, thunder and lightning. I'm gonna go so I can pick out some more fat watermelons. See you guys at home, all right? Got the cactus, the fire loaded up. Boom. And we're off. All right, guys, so now I'm back in the store. Before I finish up my lengthy day of things to do, it's a normal Monday. I got meetings, I got emails, same things that everybody else has on a Monday. Just basic work. With that being said, I gotta feed animals, clean animals, take care of new ones, move guys from quarantine, do cage repairs, still work out. Just, it's a lot of stuff to manage on Mondays because a lot of people don't work the weekends. I work every single day and I love it. That's why I always encourage you guys to do something that you're passionate about that doesn't burn you out. And when you do something that you're passionate about, also includes certain side hobbies that keep your mind fresh. You don't want to keep doing the same thing over and over and over. You could get bored from it. So you gotta make sure you're enriching yourself. That's why I always say to make sure you guys have something cool to do on the side, like working out, or going to play paintball, or doing gymnastics, or yoga, or you know, watching UFC fights, or going to the mall and, I don't know, girls get your nails done, or guys go buy some new basketball shorts. Something cool like that. But for right now, before I start unpacking the car from all the fruit that we got now, I'm gonna show you guys a quick little diet I'm making for a little anteater buddy. Now I got some regular water. I got my little Nutribullet. It's like a blender. I've got some yogurt and some honey. Now our main ingredient is gonna be Missouri insectivore diet. Now this is basically the substitute of the dietary supplements an animal would need in captivity. If you're feeding an animal such as an anteater, what is he gonna eat in captivity? I can't go buy 9,000 ants a day or even start my own little ant farm. That would be cool. Maybe we'll do something like that in the future. You know, but as of right now, I don't have the tools to make that or the knowledge to start an ant colony. So in the meantime, I have these small little pellets that actual zookeepers use when they feed animals in captivity. This stuff is mainly for animals that only eat insects. Now, this anteater, not only does he eat ants, he loves termites as well. So I'm sure inside the ingredients, it has everything you could possibly need for the animal to enrich them for all the vitamins, supplements it needs. So now I've worked with anteaters in the past, giants and smaller anteaters, AKA the lesser anteaters. And they had this nice little treat of honey and a little bit of yogurt inside of their insectivore diet. Now, of course, they're not gonna find yogurt in the wild. They could possibly potentially raid a bee's nest and search for some bees or, you know, smaller bee larvae, but I'm pretty sure it's not unheard of, but it's not common. But you can never put it past a wild animal to do wild things like that. The honey and the yogurt is a good substitute, like I said, just for keeping it nice and sweet for them. Give them like a nice little treat. So now I take that, I got my honey in there, I got my yogurt, and I'm gonna pour my water in. not much water, about that much. I put my top on. Stick her in that little NutriBullet and I guess it's like on a different setting. Alright, so now that it's all nice and ground up, looks like a nice little protein shake full of insects. So I will take this. Now, I had an insectivore diet in my food collection for a while now. I'm from Missouri. I have a Savannah monitor. He likes to eat insects. That's one of their primary staple diets. One of the only monitor species in the Varanus family that loved to snack on insects, even as adults. Now, as you guys know, a lot of small lizards love to eat insects on their way up from being babies to full-grown adults. So Savannah monitors haven't really lost that touch of loving insects. So what I do, sometimes when I'm out, especially during COVID, a lot of stuff can't be shipped and stuff. Everything was backed up from super worms to roaches to all types of little insects that would feed for good protein for my lizards and some of my little tortoises as well too, turtles. They like to eat little insects, like little box turtles and stuff. But I would take a little injectable and I would suck out some insectivore diet and inject it into like little pinky mice. And then I would feed the Savannah monitor. Of course he would get his pinky mice, but he'd also get the insectivore supplements as he would eat a bunch of insects. So it's cool to have different things you can mix up and give to animals and they get everything they need for their life in captivity. Now I'm gonna stop talking. We're gonna make our way outside and go check on our little anteater buddy. I'll see you guys in our little anteater habitat we have. Now it's only a temporary enclosure. It is really big. It's about 16 feet long, I think about 12 feet high and 16 feet wide. So he's in a pretty good enclosure for now. But as you guys know, I love to overdo and just give these guys massive space. So I'm mentally preparing how to build him a high enclosure because as you guys know, also they are arboreal animals. So, again, I'll see you guys outside. We'll be right back. Good fucking morning, everybody. Right now, I'm making some monkey food. I got papaya, banana, sweet potato, some lettuce, and some green beans. All right. And we got our boy, Sugar Man, over there. Sugar, what's up, big boy? Yeah, so, yeah, good morning, good night, good afternoon, wherever you guys are around the world. I'm going to make some quick monkey food, and I'll be right back, and I'll show you guys our actual monkey we have. All right, so we go from here to here. Tell us about your monkey experience so far, Miss Larita. Tell us in Spanish about your monkey.
Él es muy lindo. Kiss me. El bebé va a estrenar. ¿Sí tú? Kiss me again. ¿Ya? ¿Puedo ponerlo adentro? ¿Sí? ¿No? ¿No? Kiss me. I'm super happy for you. Hey. He don't want. He wants mommy. I'll go to the I'll go to the Stay. Look. Do you like? Do you like?
I love it. You see?
Get over here. Hey, come. Get her.
Want to swim in?
Yeah,
want to swim in?
Come. Go get her. Go. That's my good boy. That's my good boy. That's my good boy. Hey, hey, hey. Sir, sit. Give me paw. I said, give me paw. Thank you, sir. Come on, let's go. Come on, go get him. Let's go. Come on. Good boy. That's my good boy. Come on, let's go back. Come on. Come on, let's go back. Come on. What a special kid, man. Love this pooch. A little morning routine. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Let's go. Good boy. All right. I did see a freaking day gecko over here somewhere. I'm trying to think where I saw that earlier. He's still over here. I love these freaking geckos, man. Where was that little booger at? I saw him. I swear I did. I swear I saw him. Somewhere. There he goes. Easy, Chucky, back up. Giant day gecko. Insane, huh? Cute little kid. There's tons of them out here. I've seen some babies. There's just someone, a nice crazy red looking one, like a crimson or something. Man, I think it's badass. I saw him like a couple days ago, but yeah, man, love those gecko kids.
Keep singing.
Yeah.
Where are you going?
Here, baby.
Have sex?
Yeah.
Sí. No, bueno. Bad moment. Privacity.
Oh. The show?
¿Qué? Kiss me, papi. Like me. Make ocean tortuga.
Tortuga ocean.
Van a tener tortuguita. Tortuguita.
Tortuguita. Tortuguita. Ok.
Están en un momento íntimo. Vámonos a otro animal. Baby.
Sí.
The next one, because it's like privacity, you know?
Privacity, you know?
You want tortuguita?
Sí.
So.
Tortuguita.
Hola. Hola, corazón. Why he is so tiny? I never see him.
Super tiny.
Well, I never seen him before.
You step in.
Come here. Bring a puppy. Bring a puppy. I say bring a puppy. ¡Hueputa! ¡Qué calor tan arrecho, mano!
¡Tan arrecho, caray!
¡Arrecho, mano! ¡Tan arrecho! Who is him?
Huh?
I never see him.
I cut the grass.
But why I never see him? Super weird.
Cool, huh?
Bro, you lied to me.
What?
You buy. Where no. You buy?
I'm a buy.
I never see him. Hi, how are you? My name is Ellen. Hello. Hola, corazones de melocotones.
Our pied pecanada, get a little snack. For a big male, come out and get some food. Thought they were struggling over to get up. We're gonna leave this in here to see if the male wants to come out and get some food. He's a bit shy sometimes.
Whoa, man, we're back again. So today is gonna be a interesting episode. As I feel every day is an interesting episode. You never know what you're gonna get. You know, one day we could be out of the country, one day we could be in the yard. One day we're doing repairs, one day we're boxing, one day we're just uploading random clips from forever ago that I forgot to post. Yeah, man. Today's gonna be our first, though. We haven't done a video, hold on. A little foggy. Every time I leave my cameras in the house, it's like super air conditioned. And then I bring them outside and it gets super foggy. But today's gonna be a day of a first of our kind video. Now, it's gonna be an unboxing video. I got two animals. I can't tell you guys what they are yet because I want you guys to guess. I can tell you one thing. One of them will be able to
tomorrow. I'm gonna work on this all day from sunup to sundown. This habitat will be one for them. So you can guess which one will go inside there. Out of the two, comment down below. What's up, kiddos? Hey, hello, 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 hi. I'll be back. I know it's been raining all freaking day. Easy. What's up, fat boy? How you doing, sir? All right. Hey, quiet. No, I need to come back here. I'm so sexy. Am I beautiful? Hi. Hello. Easy, easy. Gonna hurt yourself. All that freaking jumping. But yeah, so I'm coming back here to grab some bins because once I get them out of the box, I want to be able to place them somewhere where I can soak them. I know they had a nice long transit from leaving yesterday and arriving today. So I want to get these guys some water, some hydration. Just check on them. What are you doing over here? Get out! Look at this freaking guy. I put a freaking fence up and all he does is shit on all my stuff. Get out! Freaking goat, man. I swear. See, and this is what pisses me off. Look, he did it again. Every day he's just breaking in and having a shit fest, bro. Freaking goat, bro. Pissing me off. I'll be back. I gotta clean this up. Guys are nice and cleaned up, and we're gonna go start unboxing. Now, I've done some stupid things in the past where, like, I got really excited and just opened a box and then didn't have a bin to put the animal in to, like, resecure it, and it just starts running around the house, running under the refrigerator. Right under your bed, just madness. So, you gotta kinda like get your shit together before you take some stuff out. So, yeah. Ouch.
All right, I see you guys. I'm gonna go set up. I'll see you inside.
All right, guys, we're back. I'm set up in my room. I'm gonna go drag the box in. I got our bin set up to take them out of the box and put them inside of here. Welcome to me little room. I'm still under construction, so forgive my mess, my messy bed and stuff, but be right back. Guys, back over to the corner. Now, excuse me ahead of time if I get a little overexcited. Tell you guys a funny story before we get this video started. Today, let me turn this video on real quick. Today, I was, I couldn't sleep all night. Got the phone call yesterday, like midday, that the lizards would ship out. I just told you guys what it was, the lizards. That they would ship out, and I was so excited, I couldn't sleep last night. I even took like 2 melatonin to like go to bed, and like literally all night, I'm tossing and turning. I can't sleep, I'm super excited. I get up, I start driving to go pick them up, and I'm going a little too fast. I pass 2 cops and they pull me over. They want my license, registration, stuff like that. And I can't like explain to them and tell them like I'm excited for, you know, like going to pick up some lizards. I'm just like, I'm sorry. Just give me my ticket so I can just keep going. So they gave me a ticket for, I wasn't going that fast. Maybe like 10 miles per hour over the speed limit. This guy was just like not having a good day. But I wasn't gonna let it ruin my day. So I proceed to go pick up these animals. And I pick them up at the FedEx hub, you know, bring them back home, and here I am. I'm so excited, like, I'm actually drained because I couldn't sleep last night again. Been running around all day, but we are finally here to check these guys out. So again, if I get overly excited, please, you know, bear with me. Funny thing, on the box it says there's 11 ball pythons. So when I first got the box, I was like, what? Because it was like actually wrote on the tape, but I know it's an old box, wrote on the old tape. So this is our first unboxing video. It came double strapped. I know you guys are probably wondering like, why is there animals in a box? Well, certain small animals like reptiles and stuff like that, they can be shipped overnight. Or they can be shipped via Delta Cargo or, you know, the United Cargo underneath the plane where they ship dogs as well too, birds, all types of crazy stuff. So I got these lizards, they're professionally packed. And see how it is. I don't know what's in the first box or the second box, but I'm gonna find out. Voicey voice. Got some cool stickers. Ah, yeah. A little lanyard. Love that. Some more stickers from my little laptop. Some wristbands. All right. Okay, he's in the bag, which is good. Now I'm gonna see where I can grab. Okay. Zip tie over here. Okie dokie. So now I'm going to drag the box over here with the bin over to you guys. One's in there. Now I told you guys what lizards, but if you can guess what kind of lizards, comment down below. Are they iguanas? Are they basilisk? Are they Baja rock lizards?
Are they Komodo dragons? Are they steelfin dragons? Are they water dragons? Are they bear dragons? If you guys know what they are, if you can guess what they are, comment down below. I would love to know what you guys think they are. I'm excited. I'll give you guys a hint, all right? The claws on these animals look just like this. So, make a guess. Now, it's probably a bad, toss up of an alley-oop for a good guess because a lot of lizards have claws like that. But, hey, yeah. This one's way bigger. Holy crap. Oh my goodness. Okay. Oh man. That guy's big. That's definitely a leopard gecko for sure. Alright, now that's out the way. Start with the small guy first. Now, I'm gonna tilt the camera down a little so you guys can see what's going on over here. Right. Here is our first one. So, too scary. No. Grab the back of the bag and let him walk himself out. Well, they might be double bagged. Yep. Double bagged. Very smart. Sometimes they're not double bagged, they can rip out the first bag and now they'll be in the box, and then they rip through the box, and then there you have a loose animal on a FedEx truck or at the airport. And dear old 86-year-old Linda that's been working the front counter now has an issue on her hands. Next guy is, because that bag is humongous.
guys know I love monitor lizards. I have a plethora of water monitors from all around the world in the yard. I have other croc monitors. I have black dragons. I have black throat monitors, white throat monitors, Philippine water monitors, Kimberly rock monitors. I got a pair of blue tree monitors coming in soon as well too. I have to build a certain habitat for them with really small wire so I can, you know, throw a bunch of insects in there. They don't escape. Yeah, man. So I've been obsessed with monitors for a long time. I've had a ton in the past, growing up as a kid. I think I got my first monitor at like 10 or something like that, I believe. Yeah, man, I had a monitor in college. I snuck one in my dorm. I had a giant 55-gallon tank under my bed. Got too big, and then, like, I had to keep transporting back home and back and forth. It was fun. Needless to say, I'm obsessed with monitor lizards. They remind me of how smart they are, just like a bird. They look at you like a bird, you know? And, like, it makes me real curious about what they're thinking. Okay, now... All right, this is gonna be fun. If that's the head, then holy crap. Oh. Boy, oh boy. Usually, I sign up for crazy shit, and this is probably one of the crazier things I signed up for. Yeah, this guy's thick because the zip tie is like 10 times the size of the other ones. Is that another bag? Yes, he is. Okay. So. Big enough for this guy. So what I'm gonna do is we're gonna take this this little unboxing video to the restroom, a little bit more enclosed area. I think it'd be a little better to unbox this kiddo in the shower because he is big. I thought he was gonna be like a, you know, not saying I thought he was gonna be small, but I didn't know he's gonna be a freaking Charizard over here. All right, yeah, I'll just put you guys here for now, and then I'll just start maneuvering our buddy into the restroom. But first, I gotta take out the stuff from my shower because I know for sure he's gonna knock it down. All right. This guy's a big one. He's not little. Up there. Here. so excited. I should honestly like unbox him right outside into the habitat, which would be a smarter thing to do, but you guys know me, I ain't that smart sometimes. All right, bring my light up in here. I'm excited. I'm really excited right now. It's like Christmas, you know, when you can't sleep before Santa Claus comes, and then you wake up and your tree is just filled with presents. All right, doggy shampoo. Didn't know he had a nip tail before he got sent over, so you know, I knew it was gonna be a little short on the short side of his tail. This is the biggest monitor lizard in the world. They can reach anywhere from 10 to 12 feet. They are naturally found in Indonesia and smaller islands over there. Now you do have your females. It's okay, buddy. It's alright. You're okay. I'm probably gonna shut this so he can't escape. And then I'm actually gonna move him outside to a massive.
All right, guys, here is the moment of truth. I hope you guys are ready for this, because I am ready. Okay, so I'm gonna stick this. I don't even know where I'm gonna stick it, but I think this should be a pretty decent size right here. You know, you guys can see almost everything. Okay, wish me luck. I can't even shut that because I'll shut myself in, but I'm gonna put them up here and give them a space. I got his head wrapped up so you can't see me much, but I mean, this guy is big. Don't you fall off there. No. No. All right. He is now loose. Shorty is thick. I mean, look at this beast, guys. It's gotta acclimate, of course. But look at the size of this monster. Hey, quiet! Now, of course, the cage is fully enclosed. You cannot get out. It's pretty tight knit up in here. So I want to show you guys. I mean, that little piece he's on right there is 5 foot. So here, 5 foot. He's up to the top and he's got even some swiggle in his tail left. So I'm pretty sure he's pushing about 6.5, maybe 7 feet. But look at that beast, man. You guys up close, look at him. Now, okay, I'm gonna leave him alone. And you guys saw the freaking dragon be released. Now, comment down below what we should name him. I need help. I love you guys. Peace. Today, we have a special guest coming over. Laura Isabel León.
Hola, amor.
Hola, amor.
I'm super ugly. Hola,
super ugly, bro. Why are you so ugly?
I don't know.
Yeah, she's ugly as shit. Fail. Feo esta. Soy guapo, tu feo.
Okay, he lost in one game.
I didn't lose.
Lost?
I didn't lose.
Yeah. I win. I have one video.
You have no proof.
Bro.
I have one witness that say I won.
You lose.
No, I don't lose.
Yeah.
Sure. I never lose.
Yeah.
I don't take a L.
Yeah, for sure.
Is it hot here or is it just me?
Bro, I don't care.
That's me, isn't it?
You?
Oh, yeah. No, definitely you.
You are so good.
You're so good. Bro. All right, guys, we're going to the farm. We just left getting some breakfast slash brunch.
Breakfast.
And we got some.
I'm doing nothing.
What do you want to eat?
You.
Bye.
What?
Don't be shy now. Talk your shit. Talking all shit. She hates me because I'm handsome.
You're handsome? You're fucking perfect! Look! You scare me!
Why do I scare you?
Because look! Perfecto! Hermoso!
Perfecta!
Esta perfecta! You are fucking perfect! Look! Your fucking eyes! lashes. I don't have lashes. I don't have. You're
you have green eyes. I don't have green eyes.
Look at you, bro. Perfecto. Hermoso. Precioso. And I fucking love you. And you think I'm not scared. No, I need to be super normal. Because you are what?
Why are you scared?
A fucking girl. I told you. Oh, you're the real person. And I got mine. Mio. The person told you. And I can't say no. I can't say no.
They're friends.
I know. But you are my baby. You are Mateo. Mateo. I don't care. And then you want I'm being super normal. Look. Why you look more like that?
You have one booger. Can I get it? Can I get the booger? It's close. Super close.
This booger is dry skin. It's dry skin.
I got it.
You seem very perfect. You take my boogers. And then you want I'm gonna scare you for your loss. You
Colombians.
When you fight with me. You kill. When you say, bro, get out. You kill. My fucking hurts is break. I was like, bro, don't touch me. I feel super bad.
Yeah.
It's like, touch me. When you say, don't touch me, I want to touch you more. Because I want you want.
I understand. No! I understand.
Because you don't love me like I love you. No!
I love you like the same way, but I just don't yell at you like that. I don't say, ah, you are so sexy! What the fuck, dude?
Mire eso, bizcocho. ¿Te has visto en un espejo, mi amor? Papacito divino, quien fuera cemento para que estuvieras encima mío, monumento. No soy virgen, pero de rodillas te hago milagro. You understand?
No.
I'm a virgin, but I'm okay. Sorry. Te amo. ¡Ah!
Are you okay?
No.
No.
Tengo miedo. Why you don't love me? Why? Él piensa que para mí es super fácil, que él es super fucking sexy y hermoso y perfecto. Perfect look. Perfecto. Y yo tengo que ser super normal. Y yo no tengo que tener miedo de perder semejante cosa hermosa, divina. Pues miren esas manos. Perfectas. No es justo, pero tengo hambre. Ajá, hombre.
Right, so look, from right here. The difference is I'm in front here. Front here. Alright, so. Yeah. Let that foot step back into the front.
Okay.
Back. You can get here. You think that you're not going to touch me? Because you're going backwards, but you're not going to extend your arm all the way across your body. You're not going to.
Got you.
You're going next.
Yes.
Right? You need to go. Hey, and walk me down. Good. Yeah. Pull it down a little far because you want to hit it so hard, but you get the concept. Hey, there it is. I'm going like that. Like that. That's not that. Okay, so after that step, boom, boom, step, step upper, you need that close.
Gotcha.
Right?
Keep that back foot plane. Kind of reaching a lot. I think that's maybe more right there.
You're just leaning that, right? So
all you're doing is pushing up your front.
Slip step,